hello, we have a different angle now, because, well, I'm using one camera to unbox something, so, what am I unboxing? I don't quite know exactly what it is and how it does what it does, but here it is. It's the Gizmodron 2.0, which apparently is something, as far as I understand, kind of like an Ebo-ish kind of have the guitar ring and sing. We'll find out. Gizmodron 2.0. For any of you who are interested in the Gizmodron 2.0, follow me as I unbox this. Apparently you can get this in gold, black, and translucent. I have it in translucent. I already peeked in the box, and it's pretty cool what's in here, and it kind of like all the stuff that you need to Gizmodron it up, I guess. So, first thing that you notice is here, kind of like an apple-ish kind of little pouch. Spring amps will get bent. To reduce this, keep speed at 50% or less for the first hour until wheels break in. Okay. And in here, we have a sticker. More spring arms, I think that's what they are. And little adhesive sticky things. 12 of them. Which is apparently how the Gizmodron gets stuck to the guitar. It has to be fixed on a guitar. You can remove it without any problem, but it's not like click, click, click. You have to kind of have a guitar that it's always on. Easiest is, as far as I understand, a Strat or a Tele. Here are instructions, which I will have to go through in detail, and they are luckily rather detailed instructions. And what I just said, Strat and Tele, here they're showing it on a Les Paul. So it's clearly possible. I think it might be easier on a guitar that's not curved. On the other hand, those feet that stick on the guitar can be adjusted. So here's more spring arms, if I get this. And in here is the Gizmodron. So I'll take this out. And this is a thing, it's not small, that's what she said, that we're gonna have to attach to our guitar. And these little feet, as you can see, they can be angled, so it can be fixed to a curved top. Here's a switcher turned on. Here's probably a speed knob. And, okay. Okay, you screw these up and down for height, I get that. This is gonna be a trip. And now, as far as I understand, and please correct me if I'm wrong, there's this metal rod here that will turn, and when I push on these, it pushes these rubber these rubber wheels onto the rod, and then they should spin. And I don't know, how do they play the strings? They are little, what are they called? Zahnräder. Damn it, what is it in English? Gears on them. Maybe that's what plays the string? I will find out. I am not very informed about the Gizmodron, which is kind of cool because I'm like you. Let's find out about the Gizmodron. So this we'll put on the guitar. And now I lift this up and there's more. Neat. I like when a company just gives you everything you need. And included, oh, that's cool. That is cool. Gizmodron labeled Tiny Torx, a TT, a hex, a bigger Torx, and a Phillips. Exactly the tools you need. Here is a rather long USB cable, which is to charge it, because here you have, where is it? Here you have a USB input. This is how you charge it. You don't have to have it on on a power supply continuously, because then you have a cable running to your guitar. And who wants a cable running into his electric guitar? Oh, not for the Gizmodron. And here is a power pluggy thing. Of course, I don't want the American one. I want, come on, hello, push, it says push, I'm pushing, lock, open, Here we go. And now I just pick my European or German plug. All of them are in there, at least four of them. And bam. And that's just a USB charger, 5 volt. You can pretty much charge it with any standard USB chargey pluggy thingy. Which is cool, that makes it flexible enough to be used in any situation. So, I guess now it is a matter of me installing it. Should I film that? Probably. If it takes too long, I'm gonna fast forward. Gizmotron time! See ya. So here it is installed. Let me show you the functionality, which is pretty much these rubber wheels, when pushed down, will make contact with the turning metal rod in the back and then start to turn. If you push down more, they get pushed against the string, and with the gears on them, will vibrate the string. Or two at the same time. But you can see, depending on how you push, it's definitely an analog system, meaning, you know, the more you push, the more you're pushing the wheel, the harder it gets. That's what she said. And then
the wheel also will turn a bit because it's on this very, very springy kind of little piece of metal. On the upper strings, it's very subtle. So we're going to check out how this actually works in action.
So here we are now. I'm just looking at the dog wag's tail. That is just so damn cute. Bruno, come down here. You can't go to... whatever. So we have the Gizmotron 2.0 now installed on this Fender Mexican... it's called a Road One Tele. I can say that. So I was wrong when I said you can plug it in with USB, and then of course, you know, it's battery powered and you can use it without a cable, because I had this charge for a while, but it doesn't charge because, see, it's not battery powered. Having to have a USB cable on your guitar, I'm sorry, but that kind of negates the whole using it live, I think. But that's too much of a risk to like pull out the little USB cable. Anyway, so you can turn this on here. Then a little light comes on right there. If you can see that from the front, can you see the little light? It's pretty bright. Here you go. Okay, so and then you can hear this thing in the back spin up, this rod thing. So this metal rod right here turns. Ow! Don't put your finger in that. Okay. It is a little bit tricky to position them exactly so it's all equal. On the higher strings, it doesn't grip as much as on the lower strings. You want to make sure that the gears or the wheels, because they turn a little bit when you push on it, don't hit the string above. And when the guitar, when you don't use them, that the guitar still rings open. What do I do? This is what makes so much more sense. I'm right now plugged into, directly into Wampler Tumnus. Strymon Timeline, going into the Victory V40. And that's it. So, purely clean, let's do this on the neck pickup. Let's just push some things. I have speed, which you can set here on this knob, to 50%, which you should do in the beginning. I'm going to ramp it up a little bit because I played a little bit. That's crazy fast. So here you go. And this is what it sounds like when you push on them. So, in terms of setup, no idea. It's said to keep the strings. Show this from the front, Leslie. It's said to keep the strings under the middle of the wheels, which I have. The wheels might still be up a little bit too high. This is definitely a very, very subtle setup that you have to do here with the height of these things that you have to adjust, and then also the height of the whole thing. So let's try to play a little bit with this. And here we go. Oops, pushed the wrong one. You have dynamic control by kind of depending on how hard you push, but it's something you have to learn. It's like learning a new instrument, kind of. also go. Again, the higher strings right now are not working as I would like. So it's set up so that the strings can still ring, and that's a little bit of a tricky thing. Now the high E string doesn't grab on as much as I would want the gear to go onto it, but if I go any closer, see, it's already not ringing openly. It might be a height adjustment. But let me go ahead and turn on a nice delay. Let's find a different one, come on. Kind of very neat for exactly that. You have, I mean, I just played with it for a little bit. If you have to master it. If you master it, I think you can actually create some very unique sounds that are unlike the Ebo, because it's only one string on the Ebo, and it's a different technique. The Ebo is doing what the Sustainiac from Fernandez does, which is a magnetic keeping the string going, which is nice. This is just a different approach. It's a mechanical approach. It feels mechanical. It also kind of sounds mechanical. It's definitely when you're sitting on it, because you can hear it grinding. You can hear this. Okay, well, you just don't be bothered by it. I'm going to click on the tumness, which is on a very subtle setting. But that means it compresses a bit, so the notes will come out quite a bit more. Well, it definitely takes some getting used to. Changing here, changing there. Tricky! But you can create some very, very unique sounds. I mean, something like an F major 7. Oh. And having the pressure happen here is equal pressure on everything, or actually emphasizing certain notes, it's like learning an instrument. It somehow reminds me a little bit of a mellotron, where you have that. It's somehow even a reverse kind of an effect. Very difficult to describe, but I think. Let's see what I think. So, the Gizmotron. Do you need it? Do you not need it? Hey, if you think you need one, you need one. If you're bored with the guitar as it is, you might need one. Boy, this is loud. Thank you. If you're the traditional guitar player, no, you don't need a Gizmotron. But if you have a spare guitar lying around that you can retrofit with this, and you're going in the studio and you want different kind of sounds, mellotronish kind of sounds. You want to create soundscapes with big delays and maybe even cool filters and stuff like this. And you are the ambient kind of guy, or the kind of guy that wants to have a pad. As a studio tool, I think this is great. Because it can create stuff that is not synthy, is not guitar, it's a different world. So yes, it delivers, but it is fidgety. It's not something that I would trust in a live situation, because it is a mechanical instrument, which means depending on it live with a USB cable plugged into it, I don't know. That wouldn't be my bag of chips, as they say, my cup of tea. But as a tool to have on a spare guitar, or maybe you want to actually, I don't know, maybe you want to be only a Gizmotron player. Possible. Maybe you just like that sound and that's what you want to do. Maybe you got arthritis in your right hand. I don't know. And maybe you simply can't play guitar normally. You can't do this and you can't do this. You can still be musical with this. Why not? I mean, there are things I can't even think of, which I can't tell you about them because I can't think of them. You know what I'm talking about. So, you could see I had some trouble setting it up so that the high E string would easily vibrate. Setting up the different spacings, a little bit tough. Getting to know and getting used to the different pressures is practice. This is not something you throw on and bang, you go. It's like you've never played a piano, you can't go to a piano and play. You have to practice. This is similar. This is between piano and guitar, kind of. Now, again, I already said USB cable I don't like. I don't quite know exactly what to tell you. It's a mechanical thing. I don't quite know what I'm trying to say. I don't know if I love the idea or if I just think it's too much hassle. I think the sounds can be cool, and I would want them for a production. You know, like I'm sitting here, I'm like, yeah, it would be really cool to have this really ethereal, angelic kind of thing going on. How do I get that? This is how I get that. So it could be really cool. Now, whether you want to drop the money that this is, which is not inexpensive. I don't want to tell you wrong things, so please look it up. Links below. It is a very specialized tool for someone who really needs or wants that. Someone who's bought with a guitar, someone who can't play with his right hand, whatever. So it definitely clocks in at enough money so that you have to be sure that this is what you want. I like that the guys from Gizmotron are going along untreaded paths, that they're trying new things, and that the guitar is not done. Especially on something as traditional as this, we can go and do new things. And that's really cool. I really like that. Just like the Sustainer, just like the Ebow, just like other things that have a similar idea. Let's see what the guitar has in store for us. Put some effects on it and have fun. I want to thank Jürgen from CMS, Card Musical Supply, for sending this over. Definitely a new experience for me. Thank you for doing that. Thank you, Gizmotron. And check it out if you want something different, because that it truly is different. And I have to say this. When I first heard about it, I thought, oh my God, what a pain in the ass to install. It really wasn't. The installation was, if you follow the steps, it was quite a bit easier than I expected it. So, yeah. Links below. Animals now.
Flew high when spring began. We took our time soaring hand in hand. When you're young, you will make mistakes, but I do it again for your sweet ass cake. I love a world that is good to birds. I love you so much it sometimes hurts. When we glide, it is hard to frown. You lift me up the ground, don't wanna come down.